There are worlds beyond our solar system. Planets that exist light years away, orbiting stars, or even floating alone through distant corners of the cosmos. We call these worlds exoplanets. Scientists have discovered thousands of exoplanets so far. We've found worlds that could be covered in lava, vast oceans, even thick sheets of ice. Even planets that might have similarities to Earth, and we're just scratching the surface.
So what's really out there, and what don't we know? Could there be life on these far-off planets? Let's investigate.
An exoplanet is any planet that doesn't orbit our sun, and so these are planets around other stars or planets that don't orbit stars at all.
There were hints of exoplanets going back to 1988, but the first confirmed exoplanet was discovered in 1992.
Astronomers have discovered more than 5,000 exoplanets and confirmed them so far. There are thousands more candidate exoplanets coming down the pipeline, though, that are really intriguing.
There are several techniques that we use to detect these exoplanets. Most of the exoplanets have been detected using a method called a transit method, where a planet is going in front of the star, blocks the light of the star, and we see the dip in the light of the star. And so we can find out how big the planet is based on how much light the planet is blocking.
There are many kinds of exoplanets. There are small rocky ones, kind of like Mercury or we hope like Earth. There are large ones that are more gaseous, like Jupiter or Saturn. There are also exoplanets called super-Earths or mini-Neptunes that we don't even have analogs to those in our own solar system.
There are so many types of exoplanets nowadays. Some that I'm particularly excited about are tidally locked planets. So these are planets that orbit so close to their host star, these planets only ever show one side of their globe to the star.
We have found the nearest exoplanet to us around our nearest star, Proxima Centauri. And so it's called Proxima Centauri B. And that, I think, is my most favorite one because it's our neighbor.
So have we found any planets that we would actually classify as Earth-like? So we found a bunch of planets that are terrestrial in that they're the size of the Earth, they're roughly the same mass of the Earth as well, but they aren't true Earth twins just yet. But despite that, we found lots of planets that could be terrestrial-like planets around their star in a location where life could perhaps survive.
When we think about searching for life elsewhere in the galaxy, we can't go to these planets and test them in person. And so we're stuck with trying to study other details of the planets, things like their atmosphere or what we think the planet itself might be made out of.
We are looking for the kinds of gases that are produced by biology on a planet. For example, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, all of them together can be a sign of biology.
There are many reasons to search for life, but one that really fascinates me is the possibility of opening up whole new fields of science and to begin to try and understand biology in a way that we can't now.
It's hard to know when we might find life on another planet. What's going to be really interesting is, are we going to find life outside our solar system or somewhere else in our solar system first?
We're starting to build missions explicitly designed to look for these signs of life on other planets. I'm very hopeful that within my lifetime, we'll finally be able to answer that question, are we alone in the universe?
The study of exoplanets has expanded exponentially since the first exoplanet discovery was confirmed in 1992. NASA has a number of different missions, studies, and initiatives that all aim to expand our understanding of exoplanets and to support the search for life. These missions have collected data that scientists will continue to analyze, finding new planets as well as learning more about already discovered worlds. Coming up, NASA's Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope will launch with instruments on board that will take exoplanet science to a whole new level. This will catapult exoplanet science forward and set the stage for NASA's Habitable Worlds Observatory, a mission concept that aims to find habitable worlds or Earth-like planets around sun-like stars.
Who knows what we might uncover? Perhaps one day we might finally be able to answer the question, are we alone?